Hey guys, welcome back to Tony's Temple. I have my hosts Anthony and Billy.
Hello.
Hey. Well, we're really guests. You're the host.
Yeah. I mean, okay. Yeah. Well, tonight I'm drinking a Bloody Mary of my own concoction.
Cat piss. Just kidding. Whiskey.
It's actually cat piss.
Straight water.
And James is also drinking a Bloody Mary. He is not in the camera. He is our
technical
tech guy.
Tech lead.
Yeah, for the night.
Yeah. Yeah, so as always, Tony's Temple, where we talk a whole lot of nothing, a whole lot of everything, and a little bit of something here and there. So today's topic, I want to talk about the alien debriefing.
Yeah.
You guys heard this, right? I sent you guys the link.
Yeah, I think it was what?
It was on Wednesday.
Yeah.
All right, so I just want to make sure you guys know anything about it.
Me and Billy cut the last like boring part of end of it. We didn't really...
I did too. My coworker sent it to me, and then like it was already like an hour in, so I only caught like the last bit. It was like 2 hour debriefing. So the long story short of it, there were these three guys that worked in the military, and they were like pilots. They just fly around all day, and like they do drills, and they can make sure that the air is safe, right? But the thing is, they're finally coming out, and not only are they coming out just to talk to just random people, they're coming out to Congress, they're coming out to the government, and like making like an open statement saying like, hey. There are alien technology out there that we've seen, we've experienced, but we can't explain what the hell it is, you know? Because like back in the day, we have people, just regular, like, you know, people like you and I, just see aliens and shit, but no one would believe anything that we said because it's just regular people, right? And the government, they were able to just pretty much hide everything from everybody.
Okay.
Right, so everything's been underground. Oh, hey, government, have you seen any alien sighting? Oh, no, I haven't seen none. You know, that's how the story's always been. But nowadays, we have, like, technology, we have an iPhone, we have, like, things that we can track and, like, record, and we don't have, like, these shitty quality stuff anymore, you know? So, like, now it's getting really harder to cover up these, like, alien... They call you...
UFOs.
No, it's not UFO.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
UDP or something like that?
Something like
that. UAP.
UAP. Whoa. Thank you, James.
Unidentified aerial phenomena.
Yeah.
That's a new thing now?
And what? So, can I add real quick, these three guys, they have like solid, like 30 plus long careers in the military. Like, these aren't some random Joe Schmoes who like don't care about their name. Like, they got, you know, they're in there.
And the people they're talking to, like, I don't know half these people, but apparently they're really high in power. The only one that I'm pretty much sure everyone knows is AOC. Even AOC was in there. You know what?
Really?
No, I didn't know that. So I'm just saying, it's not just a bunch of regular people in Congress or like, you know, whatever. And like, they were talking about it. And I took a lot of like mental note of what they say. I'll run through you guys and just want to hear your opinion. All right. So what they were saying is when they first encountered these UDP, what was it? UDP?
UAP.
UAP. They encountered these UAP, right? They didn't know what to do about it. Right, so they went back, once they fly, they saw it, they went back to the base, and they debriefed it to their commanding officer, the general, whatever. The general was like, yeah, don't worry about it. You know, like, just ignore it, like, nothing, you know, just ignore it. So what they were saying is, like, only 5% of everything that's been recorded has ever been, like, you know, acknowledged. So every time anybody that flies a pilot, you know, pilot an airplane, only 5% of it is, like, people are like, oh, shit, that shit's real. Everything else is, like, you know, scraped underneath, like, the carpet.
But question is, I mean, why now?
Well, like I said, because now we have like technology to record all this stuff.
No, we had evidence back in our day too, though.
Yeah, the military,
compared to the iPhone and like the shit that we have now.
We have the normal citizen has the technology now. The military's had it for a long time.
Yeah.
We usually get the like GPS. The military had GPS for 10-15 years before we started getting it in Garmin's and our cars and stuff.
But,
so they've had it for a long time.
But you guys are saying that these three military guys are coming out talking about it, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Like imagine like if the president just came out and started saying, like, hey, look, there are real aliens. You know?
Yeah.
But but for me, what I found
is... If Joe Biden said it, you'd be like, okay, Joe.
Go take
whatever
your bed.
Whatever you say, buddy.
Or Trump. I'd be like,
Apparently, this shenanigan happens so often that they have drills and they have like, you know, like pep talk, and they're like, "Hey, if you guys ever see any UAP, here's what you do." You know what I'm saying? It happens that frequent where they have like, you know, orders on what to do when it happens, right? And another thing that we're saying is when they saw these aliens, it's what they explain is a dark or gray square in a sphere.
Okay.
Or something like that. Or like a gray sphere within a square. Yeah, it was a gray, dark and gray sphere in a square. And the square is like glass. But they can't see anything inside of it. Huh. So that's what they used to explain it. And like one of the other UAP that they saw was like the size of a football field.
Hmm.
So these things are fucking huge. Right?
And on Earth.
On Earth.
Yeah.
Invisible.
Yeah.
Kind of. Yeah. No. They defied the law of physics. Because they were able to travel from like A to B.
Super fast.
Super fast. Yeah. And one of the things that the guys were talking about is the technology that they experienced. We're probably not going to get anywhere near it within at least 10 more years.
Yeah.
So we're that far behind too, to like these technologies.
Right.
Like,
I'm sure 10. They experience. I'm sure there's hundreds.
We just got VR from Apple. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Okay. I just feel like there's so much evidence out there. And it's just them to come publicly now, just kind of like we know this. I mean, most of the citizens.
Yeah, but like who in that level of power has
openly said it? I get it. That's cool.
Have y'all heard about the Las Vegas sighting?
No.
Okay, so these Las Vegas citizens called in and said that something crashed in their backyard, and they saw like multiple, like 2 8-foot tall thing standing in their backyard.
That was recent, wasn't it?
Yeah, okay.
So
some ordinary gamers, Mudahar, made a video about it and talking about technology nowadays. Here's the thing though, it's like the video of them like standing in the backyard looking for them is like a piece of shit.
Right.
It's like
that's always
been the case. 240p and it's like, what is happening?
Oh, okay.
That was like a potato to record it.
We got 4K 60 on iPhone. What kind of phones are you using? Yeah, like
so they're using weird. Apple, they're using potatoes.
But the police body cam, when they showed up, the police body cam, he was on another call before they called in, and you see big bright light falling out of the sky on the body cam, and then those people called in and said something crashed in their backyard. So it's like okay, completely unrelated thing, but he has the evidence of it falling in the sky, you know.
Okay, so let's say before the debrief, right? Did you guys believe there was something out there?
Oh, hell yeah. Bro, yeah. I have friends that like has been like, you know, talking about alien conspiracy and all this stuff, but again, like we're just regular Joe Blow, we're just talking shit out of our ass. I mean, we can't identify anything other than like whatever we know that's on the media.
Yeah. I was talking to a coworker recently who's from Trinidad.
Okay.
So he was near like the equator, and he said like growing up, seeing UFOs was like a normal thing. And he was like, his mom used to be like, oh yeah, it's just a UFO. Like, they see him in the sky all the time.
Oh, it's like a bird.
Yeah, well.
Just another day.
Yeah. So, well, I don't know. Like, obviously, you hear something like that, and you're like, okay, sure, buddy. You know?
You're crazy!
But, I mean, who knows? You know, it's not such a populated area, you know? Like, maybe they are chilling over there. Saying. Like, yeah.
In disguise. Clouds. Have you seen Nope? Have you guys seen Nope?
Not yet.
Okay.
Nope.
Dude, this ship disguises itself in the cloud. And the cloud doesn't move. So this one girl started like paying attention to it. She's like, hold on. The same cloud is there. Every day, the same cloud. Everything else is moving except for that cloud.
Wait, this is a movie, right?
Yeah, it's called Nope.
Yeah.
It's made
with the dude from the comedians, right?
Keane Peele. Jordan Peele.
Okay, now we're talking about it. Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Watch it. Really good. Very fucking weird, but it's good. Yeah,
they do the Akira slide. You know what I'm talking about?
In the movie?
On the motorcycle?
Slide. Oh my god, yes. That was tight. That was tight. That was good. Yeah. But,
man.
I'm just saying, I feel like, I don't know, we can't be the only one in the universe.
Right. Yeah.
Right. You know?
No way.
So that's the scary thought, man. Like, either we are alone or not alone. Both of them are kind of scary. You know, so all of that has been like kind of ambiguous up until this point. And here's another thing that I remember within the debriefing. One of the government people was asking the guys, "Are these aliens a threat to us?" And he responded with yes.
How are they a threat if
they have the technology to go from A to B? You think we have anything to stop that shit?
Okay,
yeah.
I just think if they.
But that's the scary part.
They would have fucked us up.
They would have fucked us up. Okay. Yeah. But I feel like, I don't know. I think they're just observing. You know what I'm saying? Just like, they're like, we're like ants to them.
For how long?
Well, and here's
probably millions of years
already. Okay, so I was talking to that same coworker, right? And he said that he heard that, like, I don't know the sources or anything, right? Okay. But like apparently Earth's like atmosphere is very electrically charged.
Okay.
So these aliens use our atmosphere as like a charging point for their ships. So they come in and they circle around and fly around and then they
to get energy.
They take off. Yeah.
Which makes sense because there was a lot of videos of that.
Yeah, but obviously that's them just hearsay. Yeah, who knows?
Yo, and then disappearing.
I'm glad you brought that up because another thing that they say in the debriefing is like, you know, if they have this level of technology, how come they're like fucking up and how come they just randomly just crash? Like you, like the story you're saying.
That's what I asked him. I said the only UFOs we find are they're all crashing. So, they're just constantly crashing.
The guy, one of the guys actually had an answer to that. He was saying like, look at us. We have airplanes. We have like trains. We have cars. We have all these technological advancements, but occasionally we fuck up, right? Yeah. A train would derail, a car would crash, a plane would fly out of the sky, shit would happen. It doesn't matter, right? So it doesn't matter how technologically advanced these aliens are, like, shit can still happen to them, and, like, this is, yeah, that is just, like, another story. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
All right. And like, I guess another thing that I kind of want to bring up is, like, now that this story is out, there's two options. You either believe it or you don't.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. So, and it got me thinking, if you don't believe what these guys are saying, if you think like, oh, you know, these guys are just trolling us, like, how much evidence would you need to believe that aliens actually do exist, if this is not enough?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright.
Yeah. Dude, I don't know. I mean, Roswell. Mexico.
Oh! Yeah. I remember you telling me this.
Dude, so many stories about that. You guys heard about back in the day, like, after World War II happened? Fucking mad ships landed over there. No, we like captured some aliens and then we did like a space exchange program. Might have been just stories written by some guy, but I'm just saying like there was people out there saying that that shit was real as fuck. It's not just made up story. Like people, we actually sent people to their planet and they have they have aliens here. It's okay. Just look up. I forgot. It's called some type of project. I'm gonna have to email you guys.
Okay.
The fucking article, and then there's like a whole book that I read about it. James, no, the Serpo project.
Yeah. We gotta put it in request.
The Serpo, S-E-R-P-O, the Serpo project.
Okay.
Look it up.
Circle project.
Serpo.
Serpo.
S-E-R-P-O.
S-E-R-P-O.
Serpo project.
The Creole project.
No.
That sounds nothing like what he just said.
I know. They've already covered it up.
I can't find it.
Hold on.
Serpo ain't it either.
Okay, I'm gonna have to manually search it for you guys. Oh yeah, Planet Serpo right here. Secret Journey to Planet Serpo, a true story of interplanetary travel.
True story?
S-E-R-P-O. Just type in S-E-R-P-O in
Google. Oh, Serpo.
Serpo.
I thought you were saying Serpo.
I thought you say sample.
Sample. Oh, yes. Secret Journey to Planet Serpo is a book.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I read the whole fucking shit.
This sounds like Journey to the Center of the Earth kind of shit. Like what?
Okay, so
true story of interplanetary travel.
Okay, we sent 10 of our men over there.
Where's there?
To their planet.
There.
On their ship.
Yeah.
Like they came and like took us there, and then we have 10 of them here.
Hop in, loser.
Detailed, like, life experiences of the soldiers and, I mean, the astronauts that went to that planet. Only, I think, 3 survived out of the 10. And when they came back on Earth, they couldn't, like, they had, like, fucking chemical reaction or some shit, like, some weird radioactive shit going on in their body for staying on that planet too long. So they ended up dying, like, pretty badly here.
Was it Sign? The movie Sign?
Science.
Aliens can't go to Earth because the water fucks them up or something.
Well, water, that,
you
know, yeah, well, their body reacted to water very negatively.
Yeah,
it like burned them.
Yeah.
So, God, so look, maybe Signs is so good. I need to watch that.
Yeah, Signs good. Kind of a little creepy. Yeah.
Signs and another movie along the alien spectrum, Annihilation, is amazing.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time.
Yeah, Annihilation.
He asked me if I've seen it, and I told him yes every single time.
I've seen.
Shut the fuck up, he's doing it again.
It's so good.
Okay, I'm sorry to make a burn on you, man, but I haven't seen it.
Really?
Yeah.
It's good.
How old is this movie?
2015? 16?
Something like that. It's not too old.
It's not too old, but it's not too new either.
Yeah.
Dude, fucking aliens, man.
That, and then also along the same line, I encourage everybody to look up Tom DeLonge's company called To the Stars.
Okay.
Because Tom DeLonge has been very dedicated to the belief that aliens exist for a long time.
Is he on YouTube? He talks about it?
Or I'm not sure. I need to look into it more. There you go. James pulling it up right now.
Blink-182?
Tom DeLonge.
On his mission to prove aliens exist, a newfound UFO fandom, and the Kardashians.
The Kardashians are aliens this whole time. They're lizard people.
Exactly.
I mean,
I wouldn't be too surprised.
Yeah,
so like Amazon Music has like a campaign in Canada right now where they have like billboards that say Tom was right. And then they say like, listen to the song Aliens Exist by Blink-182. Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
So there are songs out there that people would listen to, they wouldn't even notice.
Well, if you know Blink-182 and you know Tom's story, then you know he's been obsessed with aliens for a long time. So the song Aliens Exist on their album is like his ode to saying, hey, gotcha. they're here, you know, like they exist.
Okay, so look, this brings me back to Hollow Earth.
Okay. Hollow Earth, episode 3.
If anybody's wondering why I'm chewing a straw, I quit tobacco. So this helps me.
There you go.
Plus I'm drinking alcohol, it's not really, you know, I usually vape a lot. But this helps me.
Continue. How long now?
Going on 3 weeks.
Nice.
Oh,
Monday or Tuesday will be 3 weeks.
Nice. Good on you, man.
It's hard.
It's your better health, right?
Better health. But
yeah, Hollow Earth.
Hollow Earth, I mean, they're saying that there are a higher alien species watching over us from the inside of Earth. You know what I'm saying? And I know I talk about this a lot.
Didn't you tell me there was like a hole in Vietnam or something? Or
oh, that's like a real thing. James, look it up. Son Dong Cave, Vietnam. I mean, that had nothing to do with aliens. It's actually a real thing, though.
It's like a contained ecosystem for like 1,500 years that's like, been in complete darkness.
Yes,
and
but
it
then,
caved
like,
in.
It caved in, and now like people are exploring.
There's trees, there's animals, there's all this shit.
No, that's China, bro. That's China. Sorry, this is different. This is another one.
How the fuck are there trees if there's no sun down there?
There's all kinds of vegetation.
And moss and shit?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's insects.
The world's largest cave. It capsided. It was a forest. It capsided. This thing has its own weather climate, just like the one in China. Just like the one in China. Dude, crazy, bro. Like, these are popping up all over the world. Like, I don't know what the fuck's going on. You know what I'm saying? But this was discovered in, I think,
1990.
Are you serious?
It's been 30 years.
Was it the China one that got discovered in 2019? The China was the
possible,
newest one.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, people been here, fucking like taking awesome pictures, exploring. It goes on for miles. It is like underneath.
It's like Minecraft.
Like Vietnam, pretty much, bro. Like,
yeah.
Hi.
That's awesome. Nearly 9 kilometers.
Damn.
Yeah.
How many miles is it?
Yo, I was gonna ask the same thing. I'm not European.
9 kilometers.
Hey, sir.
How many miles is 9 kilometers? In American, that's 5.5 miles.
Yeah, stay in school, kids. You know, pay attention to math. So you might have to depend on your phone.
We're on an imperial metric unit, right?
Oh.
Is it not imperial? We're on imperial.
We're on the complete opposite of the rest of the world.
Yeah.
We
make
US,
the rules.
US is the imperial.
We make the rules here, man.
What's the other one?
Metric.
Yeah. Imperial and metric.
Oh, yeah. So we're on imperial units.
Because US must be special.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, is it hot here?
It can be a little bit hot. Yeah, because I closed the window because I didn't want any like extra noise from the outside going in and all this shit.
We're good.
But
you don't turn the AC on?
I'll turn the AC on a little bit after this, but that's okay.
Okay, that's cool. All right, anyway, so, I mean, do we want to wrap it up on the alien things or you want
to... I'm trying to remember what the hell else they said. They were saying that there were fundings from the government to pretty much, I wouldn't say falsify, but like to discredit people that have like alien stories. So yeah, there were money that's supposed to go to, you know, whatever else, but the government ended up using that money to create programs to make people sound crazy. These people that are coming out there saying they're seeing aliens, and like, you know, the press is paid or whoever the fuck, like there's a whole bunch of people that are paid to keep the stories underneath the earth, you know.
That so, makes sense.
Yeah,
so you're saying I should just start telling people dollars to suppress
Yes.
I'm gonna call the government tomorrow. I'm like, hey man.
People that look like alien, like sightings or
right. Yeah.
Even articles about it.
Yeah, and
you might know about aliens. It's gonna take at least $1.5 million to, you know, keep afloat.
Bro, it's been working though. The thing is, like, if people do come out, they sound crazy. They sound fucking crazy, right? Especially in these documentaries, like the way they frame, the way they say, they talk about these people, like, oh yeah, these people are insane. They have no idea what the fuck they're saying.
What were we just saying about my coworker saying they've seen UFOs all the time in Trinidad? You're like, okay.
What do you think? That's like, what, 30% of the fucking population thinks that an alien actually fucking exists?
Who knows?
30% sounds plausible.
Okay.
Maybe 25?
I mean, who knows?
You know what I mean? I mean, a lot of people, even like, celebrities. Some celebrities are like super heavy into like trying to expose, like, yo.
Yeah, Tom DeLonge.
Yeah? No. I mean, like, movie actors. Sorry.
Sorry.
You know. Yeah. Not musicians.
Yeah, sorry.
Hollywood actors.
Okay.
Okay, Kid Cudi.
Yeah.
Okay. He's like, I think he's into like flat earth or some shit. I don't know what the fuck that's about. But, I mean, there are celebrities that are like heavily into aliens and believe in
these celebrities are, they're just human beings just like you and I. You know, they have their own ideas, they have their own thoughts, and like, just because they're celebrity doesn't make it any more credible.
Yeah.
But that's different from the government. You know what I'm saying?
Don't Joe Rogan believe in aliens?
Hell yeah! Dude, that's all he ever talks about. Bro, you know what Joe Rogan does? Anytime that he... you would tell me your story about your Hot Pocket experience, right? He's like, oh yeah, Hot Pockets, you aliens, technology involved. he just like somehow just circulates back into alien technology every single time. You know, the opportunity comes up, you know. Oh yeah, I took DMT. Oh yeah, aliens, bro. You see, like,
I want to talk to Joe Rogan about aliens.
Dude, I would love to talk to Joe Rogan, man. Yeah, like, come back like from like 5 years now, I'm on Joe Rogan podcast. Like, yeah, I said that one time.
Man, I saw a clip of his podcast recently about some guy. He talked about taking like a salvia trip. You guys remember salvia?
Salvia, what's it? Wait, I'm thinking sativa. No. Salvia is the crazier.
It's like the incense.
And you get that from like bark of trees and stuff. Salvia? No, DMT.
No, that's DMT. Yeah, okay. Wait. Salvia, they used to sell that in like Infinity's End. And you buy the like little incense shit. You're completely legal now.
Do you remember there were like videos of like people taking salvia and then like it was on like MTV or something. And then they were just like tripping the fuck out. They couldn't walk straight. And then like it was all on like TV. Like it was like,
It's legal now?
It's illegal. It's illegal. Okay. It was legal when I was back in high school. And I tried it with Danny, Chris Cortez, David.
Next time on Exposed.
Anyway, sorry. Whoa. Anyways, I mean, we did it. Nothing crazy happened. Like the story that Joe Rogan was talking about. Okay, talking about. I know I'm going to make this fast, but he pretty much said he had this guy on the show, said he took salvia, was fucking out for like 10 minutes. Dude, this guy had a whole other life while he was tripping.
Oh, snap.
Like, he said he was like under the water. He was like a horse.
I know you're talking about. Was that comedian?
Yes, yes.
A comedian.
So he lived under the water like for years, had a whole family, like
he lived
all this
whole
happened.
Life, right?
Like over 30 years in 10 minutes. And then when he woke up, like, he was, like, fucking choking because he was, like, used to breathing in the water.
Right.
Dude, it's crazy. Look it up. It's like, salvia, just type in Joe Rogan, salvia trip.
There was episode, whatever. I mean, this is kind of irrelevant, but there was an episode of, like, Rick and Morty where Morty put on some VR helmet and he lived out his whole entire life. And his whole life was like, trying to get the highest score. So when he died, like, he woke up to his real life. He was like, huh? The whole time it wasn't real? He was like, yo, what the fuck? I don't know, man. I'm willing to believe that. Jesus Christ, dude! It's like these drugs, dude, they mess with your psyche, like mess with like the nerves, you know. Like,
mm-hmm.
Well, they say you're accessing what we can't see normally, right?
Yeah, it's like all of a sudden we wake up with the power to see like sonic waves and shit the bats use. Fuck.
Sonar.
Something like that. Yeah.
Like
echolocation. That's the word I was thinking of. Yeah, yeah. Imagine like you never experience that, and then all of a sudden you can experience, it and you're like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
I didn't realize that my light was like pulsating this whole entire time or something crazy like that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like unexplained experiences is the best way I can explain it.
Yeah. We can see what we see normally within our allowed parameters, you know?
All right.
You take DMT, you take salvia, those parameters start to expand.
Right.
They start going out a little bit more. You can, a little more is allowed in, you know?
Right.
I think I talked about my DMT trip. One of the episodes, right? I don't know.
Did you?
Did I? I feel like I did. Okay, but I mean, we can set that for another day.
Yeah.
I had a life changing experience, you know. But anyways, keep it on topic. What was the next one you want to talk about?
So you got it's kind of old, but I still want to talk about the whole situation with Adam 22. Right? Do you guys have any personal stories with this guy before I got to tell mine?
Yeah. So
go ahead, Dan.
I heard about Adam 22's podcast No Jumper a while ago, and I got into it for a minute because he had a guy on there called Sharp, and Sharp is like no holds barred, like very blunt, like, mm-hmm. and he talks to these girls, do OnlyFans and stuff, and he's just like very straightforward with them, like mm-hmm. hits them on the head with whatever he wants. And
what? I know what you're talking about. The podcast that he has, what's it called?
No Jumper. Well,
no.
Well, Sharp started on No Jumper. Now he has the Sharpcast or something like that.
Okay. Yeah, well, he had like fucking a whole bunch of OnlyFans girl.
It's his only thing now, but it's part of No Jumper.
So I think
it is. Yeah, I'm pretty
dude,
sure.
Dude, I love that guy. Funny. Yeah. Very real.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's my experience with Adam 22, okay. No Jumper, Sharp. Yeah.
I mean, what did you want to talk about specifically with Adam 22?
I mean, did you know what happened?
Yeah, with Lena the Plug, his wife?
Yeah.
Is that what you want to bring up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, I mean, just to summarize it, Adam 22 married
Lena the Plug.
Lena the Plug.
They took, like, a wedding picture. They look very happy, right? And then, like, almost, I don't know how soon it is, but right after they got married, she wanted to hook up with, what's his face?
Jason Love?
Yeah.
Porn star. Fucking okay. Black guy does BBC contents. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So
BBC massive content. Cock. You know what I'm saying?
Right. So after they got married.
I don't know what you're saying.
Okay.
I mean, I watch porn. I know who Jason Love is. You know what I'm saying? Not like I specifically look up his shit. My favorite porn star got fucked by him. You know, and I'm like,
whoa.
Okay.
Her and Adam have been doing porn themselves together for a while.
They're in the porn industry.
Yeah, but it's always been just the two of them. Fuck.
No, and other girls.
That's not true.
And other girls.
Yes.
Sorry. Okay.
Right. It's a threesome. It's like a thing they have.
Okay.
But now this is like the first time where he's like, yeah, I guess, you know, it was like for her.
Her present.
It was like a present for her.
Yeah.
And I was like, bro.
Right, so the reason why we're bringing this up at all is like he's being a cuck, right?
Yeah.
But the thing is, he's not the first, and he's definitely not the first celebrity to do this. But for some reason, everyone's talking about it, and the reason why everyone's talking about it is like he just got married to this lady, right? And he's giving her permission or giving her a present of like having sex with another person. So okay. Now the whole internet is like kind of flaming him. And there were people who leave comment on his, like, you know, video saying, like, oh, you're a cuck or whatever. I'm trying to figure out how to say this nicely without, like, you know, saying too mean. But he was trying to deflect and say it doesn't affect him. But the way he talks about it and his tone of voice,
his body
his nonverbal shows that he's hurt. Yes. His feelings got hurt. Yeah, and I don't blame him. You know? And nowadays, I feel like the term cucking is a whole lot more common, you know, in today's generation. And, like, there are, like, feminists and, like, you know, women, you know, sex positivity thing, like, oh, this is completely okay. Women can do whatever the fuck they want and all that shit. And then, like, I don't know, man. I'm not on that boat.
All right, so let me throw this out there, okay?
Yeah.
They've been having threesomes together for how long? Long time, right?
But
have... Let me finish. So he's fucking other girls while he's fucking his girl, right?
Yes.
So would it have been better if he was also there with Love, whatever his name is?
He was there. He was the one that was recording it. You didn't know that?
Nah.
Yeah, he was recording it.
I didn't know that. So, okay. That's cuck.
Yeah. But like
but said, so would it have been better, though, if he just shut the camera up and been fucking her, too? Like, they were taking turns and fucking her together?
But I mean,
that would have been a different story.
He's been
fucking other girls at the same time forever. Right. So,
but the thing is, okay. So here's another important detail that I didn't mention. The way that she talked about the situation and all that stuff, it feel like she disregarded his feeling. She doesn't give a fuck about like how you feel. She wants to do it because she wants to do it. And then like people are saying like, hey, look, your girlfriend is kind of like stopping, you know, stepping over you. He was like, no. This is me empowering, letting her do whatever she wants, all that stuff. I'm like,
Yeah, you're letting her do whatever she wants. Yeah, all right. Yeah.
Wait, has anyone seen the video?
What? No.
No, I haven't. No. I ain't paying money for that shit. Are you crazy?
Yeah. James, get that on screen.
Hey, dude, do it on private browser, man. Don't fuck up my algorithm.
Oh, I tried to do that on YouTube for Tony. I tried being fat ass model walking down the.
No, you didn't.
Yeah,
yeah, he did.
Oh my Turning god,
yeah. But anyways, dude, I think everyone's just flaming him because he made it so publicly, yeah. And then he's getting money for it. Okay. At the same time, honestly, dude, he's already in the industry. Fuck it, he do what he wants. That's his wife.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, that's not our wife. That's not my wife. That's not your wife. You know. Yeah. At the end of the day, I think. People kind of just took it too personally, and I think they just need to fucking ease off. And
I agree.
Yeah, just be like, no, dude, he's living his fucking best life. He's having threesomes. His wife getting fucked by a black guy. I mean, come on. Is it going to keep me up at night? Probably not. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But people out there just, like I said, take it too personally. And I think that's a problem with the world. Like, dude, just let the man be. You know, he's making money from it. I mean, his daughter's going to be traumatized when she grows up. You know what I'm saying? But whatever.
That's kind of the problem. And like, where are your principles? Where are, like, your
values? Right, but that's up to them to deal with that. You know what I'm saying? That's their parenting, however they want to do it. Like, I'm not going to tell somebody how to raise their kids, so I hope somebody don't tell me how to raise fucking my kids.
Right.
You know, so just, I'm like, dude, fuck that, whatever. You want to let her fuck another Indian guy or another black guy? Hey, man, that's cool with me. You know what I'm saying? Show me some videos. Lena, Lena, whatever. I check plug. Off to her, you know what I'm saying? Jeez. Sorry, babe.
Plugged.
Sorry, babe. Yeah, no, I hear you.
My wife's listening probably later to this. But yeah.
Dude,
so
I didn't even know who this Adam 22 guys until like the whole cucking thing started happening. And then like I was on the hub for no apparently, just for research. I was on the hub.
Right. You saw it.
No. I was just like browsing. I was like at page 49, but then eventually page I found 49.
You found?
No. Anyways, no. His name 49? Came up. 49.
What the fuck were you doing?
The point is, you're missing the point, right? So, okay. I was just browsing and I saw his name. I was like, wait, I just saw this guy. I heard this guy on YouTube. And was like, I didn't know that he was doing porn, and like I was kind of like observing.
Okay.
You know, and he does a lot of videos with women. Like you guys said, there's never any dudes, or at least I haven't seen any. Like I introduced with like a podcast or whatever.
Okay.
So it kind of feel like he was like banging all these women, and then like his wife or his girlfriend at the time didn't get to experience that. So now that they're married and that he gave her the permission to do this, she's doing it outrightly to disrespect him, and like, you know, and he didn't take it very well on the internet, and it spiraled. And that's kind of like I kind of agree with what you're saying. Like, none of my business. You do whatever the fuck you want. I don't give a fuck. But he is promoting, you know, cucking is normal. This is empowering for women, all this shit. And then, like, people are...
Wait, did he come out straight up say that?
Cucking yeah, no. He made, like, a whole video saying, like, oh, you know, yeah.
It's normal?
Yeah. I mean, he didn't faze him. That's what he was saying. And then, like, you can hear his tone of voice. And, like, yeah, that's why we're talking about it. It's not... By the end of the day, like, I really don't care. Mm. I mean, you don't care. Whatever. But it's just some point.
It's funny because people are fucking flipping shit about it. Okay, yeah. That's what I think is funny too.
Yeah, because like he's definitely, like I said, he's not the first. You know, so like why are we picking on him? Maybe his reaction to all that and the criticism is why, you know, and like that's at least that's my theory.
I'm drinking that.
I know. Could have caused fucking damage.
I'm touching my feet.
I'm gonna pour it on his, you know what I'm saying, water drip drop.
Capsule. Drippity drip.
Clippity clip. Alright, anyways. Adam 22, bro, if you ever see this, hey man, do your thing, bro. You know what I'm saying? If you wanna get fucking the ass too, fuck. You know what I'm saying? That's up to you. So
bands.
Make sure your wife records it.
Yeah, shit. I mean cucking, whatever. Whatever you're into, man. Hey look.
That's pretty much what he's doing. He's getting paid, right? And then like people think this is cool. Like, no, like you're pimping your wife out, bro. I mean, whatever.
That's not, I mean whatever. I mean no disrespect to him, but whatever they're into.
Yeah.
What's the next topic?
Well, was it you, James, that sent me the NPC TikTok?
Oh.
With a girl?
Yeah. You don't want to.
It was Game. It was Game.
Gang.
Yeah. Wait, yum. Yummy.
Cherry.
Oh, no. Chocolate.
Oh, my God. Dude, it's so cringe. And then
it's so cringe.
They want to act like Japanese, like, oh, baka. Like kind of just like fucking lifeless. Oh, my God, dude. It's so cringy, like my skin is crawling.
Was the girl that
James? Can we get one of those up on screen?
My cherry crush. My cherry crush was the girl that made it big, and this other girl made it even bigger, and she made a video. Yeah, it was her. It was her.
Yeah, Pinky Doll.
Pinky Doll.
She's the one that
blew the fuck up.
Yeah. Can someone play a video,
bro? She can make $10,000 in a week. doing this.
No, $10,000?
Or some shit, like some crazy astronomical number, bro.
Can we have James turn the AC on?
It's even worse. It's even worse.
James, can you turn the AC on?
Gang, gang, balloon. Gang, 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 gang. Mmm, that was good. Lemonade. Hee-haw, yes. You got me feeling like a cowgirl. Am I right?
7,000 in it.
Hee-haw, yes. You got me feeling like a cowgirl. Am I right? Huh? Slay, huh? Slay, huh? Slay, huh? Mmm, ice cream so good. Gang, gang. Gang, gang. Slay, huh? Oh, thank you, Stuart.
So this is all day? Yeah. Would you, if you could get paid like $7,000 a day?
Yeah.
Gang, gang. Gang, gang. Gang, gang.
Gang, gang.
Mmm, ice cream so good. Gang, gang. Gang, gang. Gang, gang.
Gang, gang. Bro, the reason why I get upset about this, it's not her. She's playing the game. You remember back in Twitch, where there used to be like a whole bunch of metas that women would do to get like views? Remember the hot tub meta?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There was a cleavage meta. There was a pool party meta. There were a lot of ways that women would use to like pretty much get audience from lesser men. I mean, I'll say it. You know, the people that enjoy this kind of shit,
another tactic.
Yeah, you know, just like sucker in men that are like desperate for any level of attention from like a beautiful woman. And yeah, I don't blame her. I blame mostly the men that are weak. You know, and you guys know me. I value like masculinity. You know, and we shouldn't feed into like shit like this. And despite how much money she makes, she's gonna be forgotten within like a week or maybe like a month. No, people are gonna move on. It's just like a trend that's going on right now. It's really stupid, but it blows the fuck up, and it's insane. And like that's kind of why I want to talk about it just a little bit. It's just like it's nuts, dude.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm not feeling it. It's so cringe. I don't know why people. Like, who's the fuck's into this shit?
Guys
that want like a little bit of attention.
Yeah.
You know, and they're willing to drop like a lot of money.
They spend $2 to $100. Sending her little things so she could go, ooh,
I kind of do blame her too, because she knows this, right? And she actually takes advantage of these people. And you remember, you know, when you're playing a video game, right, and you're buying coins in exchange for money, right? It's never a one-to-one ratio. You pay $1, you don't get 100 coin. You get like 50 something coins, right? The numbers are always off, so it's easier for you to lose track of how much you're actually spending. So and for most cases, right, the more money you spend, the better the deal is, right? But for people like her, you can buy coins, but the numbers are kind of messed up. Let's say like you spend 100 coin, spend $2, you get 100 coin, right? You spend $3, you expect to get 300 coins. Well, you actually gain like 250, for example. Now you're getting less.
Yeah.
You know, but you get so lost in like the conversion, you don't even notice it.
But if you spend $5, you get 500 coins.
Yeah, or
so
some shit.
Spend
like,
the $5.
Yeah, so like there are like tactics that people use, you know, and like I don't know, man. I
wonder like how long does she do that for a day? Because that's live streaming, right?
She breaks character from time to time. I think she had like a daughter where like the daughter came up to her and she was like, "Hey, go away, stop doing that. Mommy's trying to do something." And she broke out of character.
That's why I keep seeing like parody comedy videos about it, and the people are like, "Shut the fuck up!"
Yeah,
they're like, "Be quiet, gang, gang,
gang, gang." Ice cream, no. Yummy.
All right, so like her daughter's sitting there watching her do this all day, and it's like,
what the crazy thing is like nobody does as good as she does though.
Yeah.
Yeah, like
yeah, they're
paying attention.
She's just like, I mean, you just watch two
sample.
No. I think James is right, because there are other people that was trying to do what she's doing, but like they don't put in the effort into like the makeup, the lighting, the quality of the video. Like, you know, she got it. She got the formula down pat. You know, so
who like
she really is an NPC?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you guys know about the other girl that used does the NPC like the GTA NPC, the white girl?
No. The actual she's trying to pretend like an NPC. Yeah, walking through the walls. And like spinning around circles.
Yeah, the
and
girl like short hair.
Yeah, that's the cool NPC.
Yeah, she's one. Yeah. Okay, she's horrible.
Yeah, because it's funny.
This shit unacceptable. I don't know, dude. It's so cringy. I'm getting goosebumps. I'm getting goosebumps. This motherfucker's actually paying for this shit. Like, come on, bro.
Yeah, weak men, dude.
That's crazy, bro.
Yeah.
What did I say?
Does he have a TikTok? You can try it real quick.
Good times create weak men. No.
Yes. Good times create weak men. Hard times create strong men.
Yeah.
Because we're getting too damn comfortable.
Yeah. Strong men create good times.
And
something
TikTok?
Like that. Oh.
No.
Do you have TikTok?
I do. I uninstalled it. I don't have it.
Yeah. I'm not looking that up. Getting it in
Can't
my
show
algorithm.
That to kids. No. Oh, bro. Now that I remember, you remember how I showed you the Kobe Zoo and all that shit? Yeah. No. Okay. So long story short, I'm on YouTube, right? And I see a whole bunch of like YouTube shorts, and I would see video of women with like big cleavage, or they're standing like very prerogatively wearing yoga pants, all that stuff, and they get 19 million views, or like, you know, 2-3 million views, like. Ridiculous number just because of like, you know, their femininity, and I get why people would click it, but like if I go on YouTube and that's all I ever see, and like I don't see any other content get any kind of level of exposure to that level, like what does that say? You know, like am I being like I'm not gonna say it, but am I being anything right now?
Well, say it.
No, is that sexist in any way? It's like why the fuck are women being promoted like sexually, well, but at the same time they don't want to see sexualized.
Yeah,
it's called a double standard.
Yeah,
right.
I guess
would that be called double standard?
Yeah, I mean they can go around being NPCs and all that stuff, but they still want to be treated like, as if they're like
should be like a human. But here's my titties.
Yeah,
yeah.
Like, you know what the fuck?
Amaranth,
but they get rewarded for it though.
Amaranth is selling her bathwater. Yeah.
Okay, wait.
And fart jars.
Tons of money. Yeah.
But didn't she go from like a bad guy to like a good guy?
You know, she actually has her own fleshlight.
She does? Mm-hmm. Amaranth does?
Mm-hmm. She does.
Damn, she's making bang.
Dude, hell yeah.
That's crazy. Do you guys miss the part where I said I actually have one of her fart jars?
No, you don't. Shut up. You're lying.
I'm lying. No, I saw some guy. I saw some guy like opened it. They're like, let's just test it. Let's see if it's legit. Fucking opened it live on stream.
Oh, dude.
Snipped it out. He's like, oh, fuck, what the fuck? He went crazy. Like, I was like, dude, that's some real shit, though. Like, that's what you're paying for. You know what I'm saying?
That's the one and done thing, though. Gone.
Yeah, it's gone. How much did it cost?
$1,000.
No, but get the fuck out. Shut the fuck up. No way.
Look it up. It was like $1,000.
Yeah. I was going to say like 40. About 1,000?
The smell of fart.
Yeah.
Of her fart. That's the thing. Amaranth fart jar.
See, fucking up my Google search, man.
A M O.
Dude, when I'm at work.
Does it pop up?
No. When I'm at work, I logged into my Google account, you know, so occasionally it will come up with like, wherever the hell I search on, you know, my
work
account. Yeah, like I don't search for it at work. It's just it's on my account when I'm at home.
Somebody's gonna walk by Monday and see Amaranth fart jar.
Oh, fuck. Damn it, James. You fucked it up.
It says $1,000 fart jars.
Oh my god. Okay, I thought y'all were trolling. Holy fuck.
You know, this is a real shit, bro. Some real shit. Yeah, I'm cursing a lot. I'm sorry. I'm a little lit.
Oh, yeah. I kind of gave a little bit too much. What is like your third cup in?
I'm good. Oh. Now the AC's running, I'm feeling great. Mm. How much time we got?
I don't know, man.
We got about 30 minutes. Now. Give or take,
yeah,
it'll be an hour and 30.
Right.
So, what's tipping was one of the topics we want to talk about, right?
You guys, why tipping? You guys want to start?
Like tipping for like generals.
I have a heavy opinion on that, but I'll share my opinion last.
Okay, I've been working uptown a lot recently, right? So you go to Starbucks. I've been eating out a lot more because we got a bunch of money from scrap metal. We got a bunch of money, so we use that for. Lunches, you know, pay for everybody's lunches. Mm-hmm. Pretty much every single place you go to, the iPad, ready to go. 1%, 2%, 3%. Starbucks, you just order it at the cash register. What do you want? Let me get a venti cold brew with 2 pumps, bada yada yada. Turns the thing around, it says tip. $1, $2, $3. I'm like,
you can do zero?
Who's this going to, huh?
You can do zero?
You can.
You just hit no thanks. Yeah.
No tip, yeah.
But I'm always like, all right, $1.
Yeah.
Sure. $1. Who's that going to? Is it a collective? Do they all get that at the end of the night? I'm doing it on an iPad.
That's what I'm saying,
it's
dude.
Digital. So how's that tip getting distributed, you know? Mm. You should just be a jar of cash that people split at the end of the night. Yeah, it's... So I had Safelite come out and replace my windshield recently through my insurance, right?
Right.
It was a $100 deposit. After the guy's done, I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, do I tip this guy? You know?
Right.
The guy's out in the sun, hot, changing my windshield for me. It was very cool, very nice, right?
Right.
I'm like questioning if I give this guy a tip. Like, if there's anybody I want to give a tip.
Well, the difference between that is you're not obligated. No one is forcing you to do it with like making you feel bad. if you turn him down.
Yeah.
You know, but like,
he's not handing me an iPad with a thing at the end of the thing going.
Yeah.
25%? I don't know. We went to eat in Southend, right?
Right.
You pay the bill now, the girl does it right in front of you on the thing.
Yeah.
And she's like,
bro,
you're
like, bitch. Bro.
Yeah, you're
so, like, so here's the thing, man. They know this. Like, these are, they're using like psychological attack to like to fuck with you, man. Like, you know how like you read left to right? Well, the percentage usually go from smallest to biggest, right? But these motherfuckers will put like 25% in the beginning because they know people will click the one on the left first. So 25%, 20%, and then 15%. You know, because like back in the day, 15% used to be like, hey, thank you, you did a good job. Here's my, you know, I'm grateful that you helped me. But now you give them 15%, it's like an insult. Oh, I didn't do good enough? You should have gave me like 50%.
Well, I've always heard that 20% was the standard.
No, it's always 15. What are you talking about?
I've always heard 20%.
No, 15%. The rule.
Was that 18? That was 18.
No, the rule of thumb is two,
fair ground.
Two for every 10 minus a little bit. That's my rule. That's how I do like quick math in my head. You know?
Okay. Yeah.
And here's my crazy story, bro. I went to a Knights game, a baseball game, right? I went to the little ticketing system, whatever, right? And I wanted to get myself a beer. So I went to like this grocery store kind of like area where you can pick up beer, you can pick up like snacks and shit, whatever. I got my stuff, and there was nobody working behind the cash register. There was a lady that would help you, but she's not like working for the cash register, right? I got my beer. I went up to the scanner. I scanned my beer, right? And the pop-up message, they're like, oh, do you want to drop a tip? For fucking who? I picked up my own beer, and I scanned it myself. Who the fuck am I tipping? Like, what is this? Why are you asking me for tip? Like,
yeah.
Like, I don't understand that.
Yeah.
You know? Like, this shit is going, like, way out of hand.
Okay. That's reasonable. Okay. But me and Billy, we worked in, the restaurant business for a couple years, you know? Tipping, yeah. I mean, it's mandatory.
It's our culture.
I get it. Yeah. In a sense, it's mandatory because we are paid, what, $2.50 an hour?
Yeah.
And we depend on tipping. But that's a restaurant, though. Now, these other businesses that you're talking about, I'm with you on that. I don't know what the fuck my tip is going for. You know what I'm saying? Just at least at a restaurant, I know that if Billy's serving me,
It goes to him.
And
it
should, yeah. Right. I'm like, hey, look, usually I give cash. I try to. I'm like, yo, this is for you, like, only. You know what I'm saying? Right. I know that they'd be, like, trying to split fucking among everybody in the restaurant.
Or sometimes the manager don't even, like, do that. They just take all the tip.
Yeah.
Salt Bae. That's a story for another day, but Salt Bae does that.
Okay, look. Restaurants, they split up between the busboy, the hostess. Remember when he needs to pay up the fucking hostess?
I did that at a Genghis Grill I worked at, and everything got pulled together. Sucks. So my rule of thumb nowadays is like, I base off of service, right?
Yes.
Really?
So if it's good,
thank you.
Great. If it's bad,
right?
I do assess the situation, you know?
Yes.
If it's bad service.
You like talk to the person?
No. Bad service, all you got to do is look around. If it's super busy and they're like running their ass off,
right?
And they're like having a bad night, you're like
panicking.
Okay. They're super busy, like they're having a hard time.
Understandable. Right.
Yeah. So I'll tip them normal still, you know, like, okay, this motherfucker needs, you know, they're working their ass off.
Right.
If you look around, it's dead and there's nothing going on in the restaurant and they're sitting over talking to Joe Schmo by the, you know, grabbing some food, you're like, all right, fuck you. you know, like, you just don't care.
Right, so, exactly. See, I'm on Billy's side with this as well. I tip people, I tip, like, generously, but only if it's deserving. You know, like, if I go to a restaurant, and let's say, like, this actually happened to me. I went out for Tony Tuesday. I'm not going to name the restaurant, but I went with my friend. We got there. We sat down for legit 15 fucking minutes. We didn't have no waitress. We didn't get no water or nothing for 15 fucking minutes, right?
Surprised you didn't leave.
Yeah, we were talking about leaving. We were talking about leaving because it was a hot day.
It was busy.
But no, it wasn't even fucking busy. It was a Tuesday. It was a fucking Tuesday. But anyway, so it took our waitress forever to get to us, right? And then the food took forever. She did not refill my drink, right? Didn't check up on me. And like when we finished our food, we waited another 10, 15 minutes to get our check.
Charbar 7.
No, it wasn't Charbar 7.
No, I'm saying. I know it wasn't. But Charbar 7. Come on, dude. That was a Tuesday, right?
Yeah.
What the fuck? Anyways, I'm sorry.
Yeah, but the point is, like, with that level of service where if it takes you forever to get to my food, get... help me out. Didn't refill my water. Why the fuck am I tipping you so much?
But the food has nothing to do with the waitress or the waiter.
I wasn't judging the food. I wasn't even judging about the price of the food or anything. I was judging it's like solely on like the bare minimum. Refill my water. Or grab my check in a reasonable time, you know, like,
yeah.
And I get painted as like an asshole because I don't tip enough. One of my friends, the thing about one of my pet peeves is like tip shamers. Oh, I tipped in like $25 or, you know, 25%. And then one of my friends like, oh, you only tipped in 25%? I was like, bitch, am I supposed to tip more than that? Like, what the fuck?
25% is good.
That's what I'm saying. Shit. Yeah, some of my friends are dickheads, dude. They know who they are. If they listen to this, I'm talking to you. You know who they are.
Honestly, you shouldn't even pay them attention.
We're not going back to this restaurant anymore after him tipping $25 or 25%. Like, fuck off, dude. Piece of shit. Anyways.
Scratch off my footsie.
I'm triggered.
No, but dude, no, fuck that. Next time you should be like, no, you shouldn't even say anything. You shouldn't even react. You should be like, and just keep it moving. You know?
No, exactly. Yeah, that, I feel like I'm so numb to it now.
Everyone's just trying to get a reaction out of you, right. You know, by saying dumb shit like that.
Dude.
Just ignore it.
To go back to the whole iPad situation, okay, when you give the employees tip, it's supposed to help them out, right? It's supposed to encourage them to, hey, if you are a better worker, there's a higher chance of you getting more money, right? But with the whole iPad, it becomes like, hey, I need you to give me tip. Kind of yeah. Like, instead of like, hey, did I do a good job?
Hey.
You know what I'm saying?
Feed my family.
Yeah.
Have you guys seen those skit on YouTube?
No.
Oh, I'm going to send it to you guys.
What happened?
No, they were like, this funny guy on YouTube, he's like, you know, shows you the iPad, and he's right. Like, you want tip, and then the guy's like, he's like going to no tip, and then he looks up.
Grabs his hand, he's like,
yeah, grabs his hand, or like, he looks up, and the guy's like holding a baby, he's like, like, you know, it's like, I can't feed my family, you don't tip me right now, you know, it's like a situation. I'll send you the video, fucking hilarious.
Yes, I know you're talking, I think you sent me that.
Okay, but to finish my point, the whole point of tipping is to help out the coworker that did a great service, right?
Mm-hmm.
But the fact that you are forcing me to tip and you're doing a very, like, you know, psychological way where you're putting the highest amount at a crazy 30, I've seen a 30% at the start base. It goes up to like 50% tip, right? Because these iPads have this kind of system, it discouraged me to tip the employees even though it wasn't their fault. You know, like, I just get so angry seeing this, like, machine asking me for tip. Sometimes it's undeserving and has nothing to do with the waitress or the waiter. It ended up hurting them rather than helping them. Yeah. Does that make sense? You know, instead of me wanting to tip them, I feel like I'm forced, so I don't tip them.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of deal, you know? So, like, this iPad system is actually hurting the people that they're trying to help.
Yeah.
Because people like me don't want to go back there. I don't want to tip any further because of, like, you know, I'm being held to tip 30% to somebody who didn't refill my water.
Yeah.
You know, like, what the fuck?
Have you all seen the videos of the DoorDash drivers?
Who the pizza guy? No, it's the pizza guy. Right?
They don't get tipped and they, like, throw the fucking food on the ground.
That's what I'm saying.
Or they kick it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's like.
Really?
There was a video.
I don't know how DoorDash works. I don't know if they're making, like, $10 an hour, $15 an hour. I don't know if they're getting hourly.
Did you not get paid enough?
Okay. That's fair to say.
All right. Dude, there was this video of this pizza delivery guy, right? The homeowner had a video camera that was recording the front yard just in case anybody steals their shit. Pizza guy came out, right? Dropped off the pizza. It was like $20. The pizza was like $20, right? Yeah. The homeowner gave him $5.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
You right? Yeah. $5 for a $20 pizza. And the guy said, wow, you own a pretty big house. You're going to give me tip me $5? And he was like, what the fuck? And he's like, fuck you.
Yeah.
I was like, bro.
Yeah.
Am I the crazy one? Or like, is this like inappropriate?
That's inappropriate.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Yeah, so this whole tipping culture
all
in America...
All shame has been lost. There's no shame anymore.
Yeah.
You know, and I've seen that a lot lately. It's like, there's no shame. You can walk down the street looking like a complete moron and go, oh, that's me. You know?
Yeah, gang.
You're not allowed to say anything to anybody anymore.
Exactly.
You know, it's like, 15 years ago, that guy would just shut the fuck up, got in his car, and kept fucking moving to make more money. He would have done a better job, you know? But now he gets to look at people and go, oh, fuck you, and go home. Probably didn't get fired.
I'm entitled. No, he ended up getting fired.
All right, well.
Really? I'm entitled to, like, more than 50% of your money, the shit that you bought. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I had a bad experience at Empire Pizza recently.
Ooh.
Wasn't even busy. The lady was like, I think we're like her fourth table. So she only had four tables. fucking rude, dude. Like, didn't even want to start a conversation with us, just asked us what we want to order, but had a whole conversation
with the
people behind us, asking them, oh, how was your food? Oh, I recommend you this. And then, you know, we're just like, oh, here's your drinks. Oh, what do you want? You know what I'm saying? And then when she came to pick up the check and shit, I gave her like two cards. I was in the middle. I was explaining like, hey, you know, I have a gift card, the rest on this card. Right before I said, this is a gift card. And right when I was about to say, put the rest on, she just snatched the card out of my hands, fucking walked away. And I was like, Gigi saw it. She was like, oh, hell no.
Right.
It's like, I'm going to take the kids and wait in the car. Don't leave her a tip. And I was like, fucking say yes. You know what I'm saying? I felt bad. So I left it like $2. The check was like $55. You know what I'm saying? I have a $50 gift card. I only pay $5 on my actual card. But like, just the fact that you did that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, I don't care how busy you are. Dude, fucking rude. You're fucking rude.
30% tip, please.
Yeah, no.
No, like, no, no, fuck
and I'm like,
dude.
Now fuck I'm dreading to go back there, because even though I love going there, they have great fucking calamari and meatballs. Fucking calzones are great. Wings are amazing. Now I don't want to go back because of her. That creates a bad experience on my end.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So.
What do you guys think about doing to-go orders and they...
Fuck it up?
And then they, like, have a tip.
So you walk in,
they provide better service because you tip them, or they do a shittier service?
Dude,
or you go.
I don't ever tip to-go orders. Ever. You know, if anything, I'll tip the chef. You know, there's a fucking person that's packing the shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they pack it and they, like kebabji.
They're pretty much holding your food hostage.
That's what I'm thinking. Like.
The hostess did that. They go bag, put it in a bag, and put it up on a thing. Which, I mean, it adds to their job. It adds to their job. They're doing more, but.
But they're taking the tips out of our.
And the hostess were getting paid hourly. They weren't getting paid $2.50.
Mm. And they were taking our tips, though. That was the thing. You remember when I tipped them out? The hostess and the fucking busboy?
Because they were doing to go.
Dude, fuck that. Yeah. See, that's what I'm saying. I don't like that shit. If you're doing to-go's, you do not need to tip them. Okay. Do not feel bad if you don't.
So but you risk them spitting in your food.
No, they don't. It's already packed up, baby boy.
Oh,
and everything's already. You just go there. Hey, my name is this. I got this and that.
That's not always the case, though.
Pay. Oh, you're right. Just don't come early. Just don't come early. Don't
do not come.
Do not come.
No, you.
I'm gonna come.
You order your food. They tell you how long? 20 minutes? You come 25 minutes, okay? And then your food's already packed in a bag. You fucking pay for the shit. You get the fuck out. Don't tip the shit. That's it. And then you just don't even feel bad because they don't deserve
it. Oh, wait. No, I was thinking like they ask you to tip before you make the final purchase. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
They don't do that? Who? Who does that?
If you do the online order, there's always...
A tip option?
Yeah, not mm-hmm. not when you get there. Not you don't tip after.
You usually have to pay. Somebody has to pay before you,
I feel you.
Before you come pick it up. Because it's an online.
This happened with Papa John's the other day. They asked if I wanted a tip before I got there to pick up the food. I was like, fuck no. Don't deserve my tip. Picking it up, you're not delivering, you motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? What the fuck? What the fuck? Makes no fucking sense.
What if my eye hurt, man? I got a pink eye or some shit. What is this?
No, but then, I don't think you guys should even feel bad.
Okay.
It's been almost an hour. I'm going to wrap it up.
Yeah. But, they're real. You know, I appreciate these podcasts, man. And thank you, James, for saving the technical issue that we had earlier with the audio.
A billion.
I think James should be our backroom guy.
Yeah,
I'm
slowly trying to improve. Just little things at a time.
Yeah.
You know, we keep having audio issues, but like I think we'll finally straighten this shit out.
Okay.
You know, nice. I'm hoping to get Mario next time, dude.
Cause, like, yeah, there was some topics we want to talk about.
Yeah.
Town.
Tony owes us steaks and.
Yeah, he didn't even call us to let us know.
Oh, fucker, bro. I'm still counting.
Oh, he should bring us some coffee.
Some coffee?
Ooh.
It's too late.
Yeah.
I want a rice bowl, steak.
Hey, Rio.
Yeah, I'm like, yo, you
make
good,
it
man?
Happen.
This is the IOU that for being late. Actually, you didn't even show up.
Yeah, but all right, well, this has been a successful podcast.
Yeah.
Jess, can you take a picture of us?
All right. Oh God! Oh Jesus Christ!
Damn.
What did I eat today? All right, I'm hoping this might be like the.
Do you see us doing thumbs up?
What? Okay. What are we doing?
All right.
Okay, cool.
Thank you.
Well, yeah,
I appreciate you guys listening through. You know, yeah. it's fun. I'm glad that I'm bringing back the podcast. It's fun, right?
Yeah.
Can we do this like maybe once a month?
I wish.
Just a therapy session for us.
I would if I could. The problem is it's hard finding people with the right time. Everyone has like kids. Look, everyone got like working 12-hour shift. You know, someone got to go because somebody fucked up the cash register. Okay. There's always a bunch of reasons.
Okay, look. The main three people should be on here is you, me, and Billy. And then James, the bad guy, always. You know, he's the research guy, looks it up. He participates once in a while.
James, can we get that up on screen?
Come on, dude. This is perfect. This is perfect right now.
With the setup right now, like, you know, we would need the mic close to him or something.
I have an idea.
You know what I'm saying?
What if we plug a monitor up? James, bring a laptop. I'll bring a laptop, whatever. We hook that laptop to the monitor. So then that way, James see what he sees, and then he put a monitor towards us so that we see what James looking up.
Well, that's why I had this whole Discord thing.
Who the fuck can I see that for? I can't see that shit.
What? if you maximize it, ding dong.
Right here. I can see it, but it's like...
Where I can't see that shit is glasses related.
That's right, but I'm just saying, I think it'd be better if
here,
we
look.
Put the monitor.
Okay.
Damn, I can't see that.
We'll figure out more.
Yeah.
But anyways, let's wrap it up.
Yeah, it's fine.
It's fucking 12 o'clock. It's past Billy bedtime. You know what I'm saying? It's 12 o'clock.
Fair enough.
Well, this guy's sleepy as fuck.
Again, thank you guys for joining another Tony's Temple, you know?
Suck dick!
Do I have a motto?
I'm just kidding. Yeah, suck dick.
Suck dick!
Suck dick!
Get cucked.
Anything and everything.
Get cucked.
I like anything and everything.
Bye!